नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल लर्न स्टैंडर्ड 7th सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 2 मोशन ऑफ द अर्थ। हैव यू नोटिस दैट द टॉयज दैट यू प्ले विद सच एज टॉप्स एंड डिस्क रोटेट ऑन देयर ऑन एक्सिस। चिल्ड्रन, यू मस्ट बी प्ले विद टॉयज दैट वन लाइक टॉप्स। टॉप्स ऑलवेज रोटेट ऑन देयर ऑन एक्सिस। सिमिलरली अवर अर्थ टू रोटेट्स इट्स एक्सिस। यू मस्ट हैव टेकन ए राइड इन फेरी व्हील्स इन फैश। व्हाइल द सीट रोटेट्स अराउंड देयर एक्सिस, दे ऑल्सो रिवॉल्व इन ए सर्क्यूलर मैनर। हियर ऑल्सो वन पिक्चर गिवन। वी ऑल्सो सीट इन फेयर लाइक फेरी व्हील्स एंड देयर सीट्स ऑल्सो रोटेट इन राउंड मोशन। लाइक अदर सेलेस्टियल बॉडीज, द अर्थ ऑल्सो मूव्स इन टू वेज, रोटेशन एंड रिवोल्यूशन। द अर्थ रोटेट्स ऑन इट्स ओन एक्सिस एंड ऑल्सो रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन। द मून एंड द अर्थ आर कॉन्स्टेंटली इन मोशन। हियर द मीनिंग ऑफ सेलेस्टियल बॉडी मीन्स लाइक अदर सन, मून एंड स्टार ऑल्सो, द अर्थ ऑल्सो मूव्स इन टू वेज, फर्स्ट रोटेशन, सेकंड इज रिवोल्यूशन। द अर्थ ऑल्सो रोटेट्स इट्स ओन एक्सिस एंड ऑल्सो रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन। हियर इज वन क्वेश्चन, वॉट विल हैपन इफ द अर्थ डज नॉट रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन। इफ द अर्थ डज नॉट रोटेट अराउंड इट्स एक्सिस, द डेज एंड नाइट्स वुड बी नॉट हैपन। That's why the earth also revolves around the sun. Similar, the moon and the earth are constantly in motion. Means they are also moving situation. Motion of the earth, first one is rotation. What is the meaning of rotation? Moving on its axis. And second is revolution, revolving around the sun. Now our topic is, what does rotation of the earth mean? As the earth rotates on its imaginary axis, the speed of rotation at any point along the equator is approximately 1670 km per hour. The earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. The earth also rotates on its axis and the speed is around 1670 km. And our earth also takes 24 hours. It means it takes one day to complete one rotation. Why is the sun seen only during the day and the moon at night? How are days and night caused? You must probably have thought about such question. Here one figure is given so we can understand how are the days and night formed on the earth. The earth is round, so sunrise fall on half of it at time. The other half remains on the other side from the sun. It is daytime where the sunrise fall and other side is night seen. The earth rotates on their own axis. This is the axis. So the different part of sun opposite of sun alternately, the area which is sunlight gradually goes to the opposite direction of the sun, and the area which is darkness gradually comes in light. This is how days and nights happen. It is daytime in India, right? It would be day or night in the following countries given in the table below. It is daytime in India means Canada, Mexico and Brazil, they have night. Japan, Australia and South Africa, they have daytime. Now our topic is revolution. The earth takes 365 days to complete one revolution around the sun. This period is called a year. It revolves around the sun at the speed of approximately 1780 km per hour. The earth moves continuously on a fixed imaginary path called an orbit. This orbit of the earth is not round, but it is elliptical, yani ki oval. This is the reason why the distance between the earth and the sun does not remain the same throughout the year. Our earth takes 365 days. It means it takes 1 year to complete the one revolution around the sun. This period called 1 year. It revolves around the sun. Our earth is also revolve around the sun at the speed approximately 1780 km, and the earth moves continuously on a fixed imaginary path. That one is called orbit, and this orbit is not in a round shape, but it is in oval shape. This is the reason why the distance between the earth and the sun does not remain throughout the year. The earth revolves around the sun the speed of approximately 1700 km. The moon revolves around the earth, and the earth revolves around the sun. The earth makes an angle of 23.50 degree to its axis and 66.50 degrees to its orbit. The tilting of the earth on its axis causes the varying length of the day and night, also change in season. Now the moon is also, this is the moon, and it also moving around the earth, and earth also moving around the sun, and earth makes angle 23.50 degrees and axis is 66.50 degree to its orbit. The titling the earth, titling means a legal right. Legally, the earth is also on its axis, whose varying length of day and nights also change in season. It means it's also not change in day and night, and also it change in seasons. Now here our topic is varying lengths of days and nights. The rays of the sun fall vertically on the Tropic of the Cancer on 21st June and on the Tropic of Capricorn on 22nd December. Wherever the rays fall vertically, days are longer. Wherever they are slanting, the days are short. The two tropics are in opposite hemisphere. The sun rays also fall where it is fall in vertically. That one days are longer, and where the sun rays fall slanting, the days are short. And both the tropics are opposite hemisphere. Thus, the reason is the northern and southern hemisphere are opposite. Look at the diagram and answer the following question. Our topic is seasons. The earth rotates on its axis in the same direction while revolving around the sun on its orbit. Due to this, the North Pole faces the sun at regular intervals. The rays of the sun fall vertically either on north or south of the equator. This causes variation in the length of the days and nights. Those parts of the earth which receive more sunlight experience summer, while those that receive less sunlight experience winter. The northern hemisphere experiences summer in the period between 21st March to 21st September, while it is winter in the southern hemisphere during that period. The change of season is a phenomenon that directly affects human life. Here we have explained the circle of the season. The earth revolves around the sun and keeping its axis inclined the same direction. So both hemispheres come opposite the sun alternately. The sun rays fall straight vertically. It means straight. Where the straight falls, it called summer. Where the receive less sunlight, experience winter. So the slant rays give less heat, night is longer and the days is shorter. Here is revolution of the earth. List of some festivals and seasons of their celebration is given below. When we celebrate a particular festival here, name the seasons experienced at the same time in a different country, find out and complete the table. Sun at midnight. Here is one picture given the sun at midnight in Norway. In the European nation of Norway, the sun does not set from mid-May to the end of July. This means that sunrise and sunset are simultaneous. So the sun is seen even at midnight. Here we have question. Why is Norway called the country of midnight sun? Norway is in the northern hemisphere between 21st March to 21st September. The northern hemisphere remains tilted towards the sun. During this period, the sun does not set near the Arctic Circle in northern hemisphere. In the middle May to the end of July, the sun continues shining even at 12 midnight. So the Norway is called a country of midnight sun.
Thank you for joining us.